First of all, I would like to thank the organizer for inviting me here today to present you an update about our safety and efficacy result of our lentiviral hematopoietic stem cell gene therapy for Wiskotoldrick syndrome. Let me start with a brief introduction about this disease. Wiskotoldrick syndrome, or WAS, is a rare inherited disorder characterized mainly by low platelet count, which cause kids to have easy bruising and possibly life-threatening bleeding manifestations. They are more prone to develop recurrent and severe infections due to an immune deficiency. They are more prone to eczema and development of autoimmune diseases, and they have an increased predisposition to lymphoid malignancies. This disease is caused by mutations in WAS gene that encodes for a WAS protein that results to be reduced in its expression or absent. This altered expression of this protein that is very important in hematopoietic cells leads to multiple cellular defects, both in platelets and all types of leukocytes. This treatment, gold standard treatment at present for this disease is hematopoietic stem cell transplantation from HLA identical sibling donor or match unrelated donor. However, this option is available for a minority of patients and is still associated with an increased risk of complication and long-term morbidity and mortality, especially when performed in older patients and when mismatched donors are used. Previous experience with the retroviral vector showed that gene therapy can be a valid option for this disease. However, previous experience with the retroviral vector showed also its limitations in terms of safety, with an increased incidence of insertional mutagenesis, leukemia, and leukemia development. However, recent experiences with different gene transfer approach based on lentiviral vectors provide early follow-up proof of safety and efficacy of this alternative approach. What I'm going to present you now is a summary of our latest result of our phase 1-2 clinical trial of lentiviral hematopoietic stem cell gene therapy for Wiskotoldrick syndrome that is based on the use of a lentiviral vector that is self-inactivating and controlled by sequences of the human physiological promoter. This is to allow a more physiological expression of the transgene and to reduce the risk of insertional mutagenesis. Our trial started in April 2010, and we published the first early follow-up results in 2014. So far, we have treated a total number of 8 WAS patients, all affected by the classical form of the disease, and all fulfilling inclusion criteria. Importantly, all of them lacked an HLA-identical sibling donor, and the youngest one, the one below 5 years of age, also lacked an HLA-identical matched donor international registry. The aim of this study was to evaluate the safety and efficacy of this treatment in this disease, and this trial was initially founded by the Italian Telethon Foundation, but last year, in 2014, GSK has become the financial sponsor. This is basically a summary of our treatment design, and the stem cell source are patient's own stem cells, either from bone marrow or mobilized peripheral blood. Patient cells are purified on day minus 3. Then between day minus 2 and minus 1, they undergo 2 cycles of transduction with our lentiviral vector encoding for the WAS DNA under the control of the promoter that I already mentioned you before. And after washing and resuspension in normal saline, they are infused back to the patient on day 0. In the meanwhile, patients receive the reduced intensity conditioning between day minus 3 and minus 1 based on weight and targeted busulfan and a dose that is approximately the half the one that is usually used in an normal hematopoietic stem cell transplant, and a reduced dose of fludarabine. Of note, on day minus 22, they also received a single dose of IV rituximab to deplete potentially autoreactive B cells. This approach led us to correct the genetic defects in most of the patient cells and in most of both peripheral blood and bone marrow lineages. And this led us to restore the expression of WASP protein in most cells. I'm not showing you all the data today because tomorrow I will have a more comprehensive presentation, but what I would like to show you is the clinical results in these patients. And importantly, the reconstitution of a functional immune system led this patient to have a clear clinical benefit in terms of reduced frequency of severe infections. In fact, we performed a preliminary analysis on the first 6 treated patients with a follow-up greater than 2 years, and what we noticed is a marked reduction in the incidence of severe infections as compared to before gene therapy. Importantly, all of the patients with follow-up longer than 1 year were able to discontinue anti-infectious prophylaxis, and most of the patients were able also to discontinue IVIG supplementation, and all of those who received vaccination developed specific antibodies. What about the thrombocytopenia? The correction of thrombocytopenia led to protection from bleeding events, and we observed both a reduction in their rate over time and also in their severity, and we did not record any severe bleeding events after treatment. This is a summary of our safety and efficacy results, and what we observed is an evidence that our approach is well tolerated by patients and led to a sustained clinical benefit. The high level of gene correction that we obtained result in a robust engraftment of gene-corrected stem cells, and that led to restoration of WASP expression in both in platelets and leukocytes, even if combined with a reduced intensity conditioning regimen. Importantly, with regards to safety, we did not detect any serious adverse events related to gene therapy during follow-up, and of note, we did not observe any evidence of abnormal clonal proliferation up to latest follow-up. And I did not mention you before, the first patient is now at 5.5 years of follow-up up to now. And we performed a careful analysis of lentiviral integration, which showed a polyclonal pattern without no evidence of skewing for proto-oncogenes. Of course, prolonged follow-up will provide additional information on both long-term safety and efficacy of this treatment. Before concluding, this is a teamwork, and so I would like to acknowledge all my collaborators who contributed to this study. And thank you for all your attention.